Hello guys, so in the last recording we explored some of the problems or disadvantages of the first circuit that we explored with common emitter, okay? And here we're gonna modify this circuit. It's the same circuit, exactly the same circuit as you see in the screen, but I just added this new resistance RE, which we call degenerate resistance. It's a resistance between the emitter and the ground. And this this resistance will, will improve some of the problems that we saw with the circuit that doesn't have this degenerate resistance, basically. Okay. So I'm gonna assume again that the DC is correct. We are working the active region, And I'm gonna just go to the EC analysis, okay. And define our input, our output, and the voltage gains. Okay, so let's go to the AC analysis. In the AC analysis, we first cancel all the sources. We have here one source, VCC. It's basically originally was something like this. Battery between this point, this node, and the ground. So we're gonna cancel it by making a short circuit like this. Then we're gonna, short the capacitors as well in AC. And replace the transistor with its small signal equivalent circuit. So let's do that. So we have the emitter, we have the base, we have the collector, we have the emitter. So between the base and the collector, we have R by. Between the collector and the emitter, we have beta IB. This is base, collector, and here is the emitter. Then between the emitter and the ground, there is RE. So it's not connected to the ground like the, the first example we solved. Same circuit without RE. Between the collector and the ground, there are two branches, RC and RL. Then between the base and the ground, remember the VCC now is ground, and it's called basically virtual ground or AC ground, because it's not ground, practically, it's just the equivalent circuit. That's why it's called the EC ground. So between the base and the ground, there is RB. And there is our signal, V signal. So let's do now our input. So our input is basically the, the resistance that the source signal C between its terminals. So where is the terminals of the source signal or the input signal? Here it is, between that point and the ground. So this is basically the way we look at our input. Okay, so let's do it. So let's go back to our normal color. So gonna remove the signal, our signal, and both Vx, Ix, or we can say directly, number one here, that our input is basically RB. So it's something like this resistance, RB, parallel with another resistance that we look between that point and the ground. It's called Rn dash. Because it's like Rn, but without RB. So let's get our N dash, okay? So we're gonna remove our B now and put Vx and Ix. Here is our E. Vx, Ix. And remember, when we put Vx, Ix, we should cancel any source in the rest of the circuit. But there is no sources, no independent sources. because we can't cancel independent dependent source, which is beta IB. Beta IB is a source in here, is basically a dependent source. It depends on the current that flows in R by, which is IB. So we can't cancel it. Okay. So Rn dash is Vx over Ix. So what is Vx and what is Ix? From that loop here, we can determine Vx, okay, by Kirchhoff voltage law. Remember, the current here is IB, as we said. The current here is basically the addition of that current and that current. IB plus beta IB, so the current here is basically IE, which is, you know, beta plus 1 IB. So from that loop, let's call it loop 1. We make KVL, Vx is equal to IBR by plus beta plus 1 IB, the current that is flowing in RE, multiplied by RE. And how about Ix? Ix is just IB, same branch, so it's same current. So Rn dash, IBR by plus beta plus 1, IB, RE, over IB. IB will go as IB with value. That must happen. You know, again, whenever you get expression for our input or output, AV node, AV, GV, it must be independent of any currents or voltages. Just resistances, okay? And the characteristics are like beta, for example, the characteristics of that resistor. So Rn is equal to Rb capital parallel with Rn dash, which is basically R by plus beta plus 1 Re. And before we move forward, let's, you know, compare this result with the one that we were, you know, that we got when there was no Re. When RE basically equal to zero, because the emitter in the previous circuits that we solved, you know, in the last videos, four videos, was connected directly to the ground. This was basically the only difference. And basically, we can do that here. You don't need to go back and look at the expression. You can just put RE equal to zero here. Okay, so let's compare it. So without RE, R input was, or RE equal to zero. Same stuff, okay? Was RB parallel R by? So which is bigger now? That one was that one, okay? So RB is the same in both. So the comparison will be between the second term here and second term here, okay? Look, one parallel with two is less than one, or let's say 10 parallel with 2 is less than 10 parallel with 4. So that one is bigger. Why? Because this is one that can be 4. So if RB, for example, is 10, and R by is 2, and this term here is 2 as well, so this term here will be 10 parallel with 2. This term here is 10 parallel with 4, 2 plus 2. It's just an assumption. You make an assumption, you know, numerical example. So basically, that one is bigger than that one. So our input now with RE increases. Then the circuit without RE. That's a good point. So RE could improve our input. Let's check our output and see number two. What is our output? Our output is basically, you know, the resistance that the output C between its terminal. So here is the output load. Here it's terminals, two terminals. So when it looks like this, it would see RO. So we're gonna remove our load and put VXIX. And when we do that, we cancel any source in the rest of the circuit. Now we have source. We have independent source, which is V signal. V signal is independent, but we can't again cancel beta IB because it's a dependent current source. So let's draw the circuit. This is where we are. So for RO here, we're gonna put VXIX. We still have RC. Then the beta IB. Then we have RE here. RBI. And then we have RB capital. Then remember we canceled the source. So we're gonna make short circuit on V signal. So we're gonna end up with only R signal here. And remember here we have IB. Good. And RO is VX over IX. Let's try to find IB. So let's take Kirchhoff in here. Number two. From two, loop two, I'm gonna apply KVL. Remember again, the current here is beta plus one IB. Why? Because the current here in that branch is IB. The current here in that branch is beta IB. So the addition of them is beta plus beta IB plus beta IB is beta plus one IB. So Kirchhoff here, let's check. So basically, RB and R signal are in parallel, okay? So we can, you know, draw that loop here, like this, RE, RBI, and here is R signal, parallel with RB, and both are, so let's do here the loop again. So the loop will be, so the current here is moving that way, so the voltage is that way. IB is moving in that way, so the voltage in that way. IB here is moving in that way, so the voltage is in that way. So we're gonna add all them together. So IB, R signal, parallel with RB, plus IB, RBI, plus beta plus one, IB RE equal to zero. We're gonna take IB as a common factor. So IB multiplied by RBI plus R signal parallel RB plus beta plus one RE equal to zero. We have here, you know, two options. So we have something multiplied by something equal to zero. So one option or solution for this is that both of them are zeros, or one of them is zero and the other is not. So let's check both. So we have two options. The first option is that IB is itself is equal to zero, or RBI plus R signal parallel RB plus beta plus one RE equal to zero. We have two options here, but we know that that term here, RBI plus R signal parallel RB plus beta plus one, RE is not equal to zero. Why? RBI is equal to VT over IB, okay? If, and VT is not zero and IB is not zero. IB, the DC guy. So we assume here that the DC is, you know, is calculated and known, you know, and IB is not zero, of course, because if IB is zero, this is cut off. We are out, okay? R signal is not zero. RB is not zero. So basically, if one of them is zero, why we have this circuit? Okay. And RE is not zero. We added it ourselves. And the emitter, of course, is not zero. This is a transistor. So that term is not zero for sure. So this left us with only one option that we must take, that IB is equal to zero. IB is equal to zero. And if IB is equal to zero, then beta IB, the dependent current source, is also zero. If you have a current source that produces zero current, that's an open circuit. So basically, this circuit in here can be reduced to the following. Vx, Ix, Rc, then open. And the rest. You have only this one, this portion, I mean. So basically, Vx over Ix is equal to Rc. So here, this is basically same as previous. So let's write this. Same as previous circuit without Re. So Re doesn't change or doesn't improve or doesn't reduce Ro. Okay. That was basically for our input and our output. In the next video, we're gonna explore the effect of Re on EV node, EV, and GV. Thank you very much for watching this video and stay tuned for the next video. Bye-bye.